What's up, guys? Spinfirearms here, back with my Glock 26 Gen 5 MOS from the factory. Now, something I finally decided to do was put an optic on it. And I wanted to make this firearm a firearm for testing different optics, budget, non-budget optics, and so on. But the reason I test budget optics in the first place is I have a lot of people asking me, hey, I have $400, I want an awesome everyday carry setup, and I want a budget, you know, red dot or green dot. In this case, it is the green dot. This is the Zulissi Owl. It uses the Doctor of the Viper footprint, which is most commonly found with the MOS is the Gen 5s from Glock. But anyways, they always ask me, how can I get a reliable setup that I can trust, that can be rugged, can be beat up, you know, that won't break the bank? Because let's be honest, we all can't go out and spend $3,000, $4,000 on these setups. We can't spend $1,500 on these setups. Let's just be real. Stuff has been expensive lately. It's been really expensive the last 3-4 years. And people are looking for budget options. That's just reality. Only a certain percentage of people can go out and spend $1,000, $2,000, $3,000 on an everyday carry setup. So this is definitely the way to go. I think it's around $100, $110. And also, they do sell them on Amazon Prime, which Prime Day is coming up. I believe it's the 11th and the 12th. So definitely take advantage of that. But yeah, this is the Zulissi Owl, and this is the green dot. I've noticed that I like green dots better than red dots for some reason. It's just how it is. So if you want to know which one works better for your eyes, go to the local range, ask if you can check out a couple dots and compare the two. But I have astigmatism in my eye, and for some reason that green works good. Now the dot looks a little big and blurry right now, and that's because it is. Whenever you send it through the camera, it causes a bit of astigmatism. There it goes. I'm trying to get it to focus a little better. Anyways, it makes it look more blurry. In reality, it's much smaller, so the accuracy is pinpoint and on point. Now, right out of the box, was it zeroed in? It was almost zeroed in. I went to the range within 25 feet. It was perfect, but once I started going further than that, I started to realize it was a little off, so that's where you just work on it. Very easy to adjust, obviously, using the tools they give you right here and right here. Very easy to adjust, very easy to access the battery. It comes with extra battery. Like I said, I've had zero issues with this at all. Absolutely love this thing. Just make sure you are zeroing in your dots. Now, are you ever going to use a dot in a self-defense encounter? Probably not. Most are up close and personal, stuff like that. But for the range and for the small chance that you might have to engage someone at a distance, I would trust this thing. I absolutely love this dot. Like I said, I like the green. And it gives you a nice, big, clear window there. Very easy to see your target. Very easy to focus that dot. Absolutely love this thing. This is the Zulissi Owl.